15 in the forefoot, but hold your horses, everybody. Pull out the sock liner. That's right, a brand new running shoe company on the marketplace. I don't even know if they're listed on Strava yet. I'll check later. Atreyu, there we go, out of Austin, Texas. Here's what's crazy, like, you test a lot of running shoes and you kind of get to know, like, what does a Nike feel like? What does a New Balance feel like? What does an ASICS feel like? Although ASICS is evolving before our very eyes. But now, Atreyu, a brand new company, again, out of Austin, and I've never even held them in my hands until right now. So here we go, a neutral road running shoe from, I hope I'm saying it right, Atreyu, spelled A-T-R-E. YU, not to be confused with the band, okay? We're not to be confused with the band. Okay, let's lace up, go get an hour test. All right, I'm gonna do about 7 miles, nice and easy, still recovering from the 50 miler, and then we will get you the stats and the breakdown in the studio, all right? So we'll see you in about 1 hour. I could not wait for the studio to share with you that sometimes, tip of the day, you gotta let a shoe breathe a little bit on your foot, meaning if it's a brand new running shoe company that you've never tried before, it might feel a little strange. And sure enough, the shoe, the first like mile or two on today's run, the Atreyu, it didn't feel great. I was like, I don't know what I'm feeling here. But sure enough, over time, and as my buddy from college, Adu, shout out to Adu, he used to say, and still says, gotta let it marinate a little bit. Let it marinate on your foot. And sure enough, I'm at mile about 5 now, and it's feeling so much better. Feeling a little bit of pop through the foot strike, so it's exciting. All right, just had to get that out there. All right, let's keep going. Now, onto the studio. And we're back. Cheers, everybody. It's just been a big week on YouTube. I need a little pick-me-up on this fine day. Okay, let me set this. There's the Atreyu over there. But first, before we dive into my first impressions, not my full review of this brand new shoe on the running shoe marketplace. And I did just check. It is not even listed on Strava yet. And that's great. Like, that is how fresh this is on the marketplace. Okay, first of all, happy Passover. I know I'm a little late for everyone celebrating Passover around the world, and happy Easter for everyone celebrating around the world, all right? Just wanted to put that out there. Also, craziness. This is, I completely spaced it. It popped up somehow. I think it popped up on Facebook today. Today is it's kind of emotional, actually, and I wish I had like a glass of champagne to raise up. This is the 4-year daily vlog anniversary. April 11th, 2016 was the first day I published a vlog on YouTube. And I haven't stopped since. It's been every single day. You all know, if there's anybody out there watching who has been watching for 4 years, let me know. I know you're out there. There's a couple people out there like, wow. So thank you for sticking with me, for sometimes putting up with my long-winded rants here in the studio. So it's just incredibly inspiring to share our story with all of you through the lens, yes, of running. All right, so just wanted to mention that. And I haven't even told True Love, so we'll go tell her in a second. Now let's dive into the shoe, Atreyu. We'll get to the drop and the weight here in a second, which is, the weight is amazing, okay? But first, the business model, something unique, something new. What am I always talking about? Innovation. I love innovation with respect to the design of shoes, and yes, the business model of running shoe companies. So here we go. Atreyu is not available yet. They're available for pre-order right now, and then shipping in July 2020. I'm gonna get into the price actually right now, for the smoking deal of $95. Under $100 for a brand new running shoe. But in addition, they're also launching a subscription service, if I can call it that. I'm not using all the right lingo, but I'm just gonna call it a subscription service where Atreyu, from what I understand, will send you a new pair of running shoes. If you sign up, the price drops down to, again, what I understand, $75 prepare. So whether it's, I mean, the details, I don't know, but it's like you could sign up for a new pair, I think every month, every 2 months, every 3 months, depending on how, what your volume is, how often you need new running shoes. And it gets even crazier. So once your running shoes wear out, again, I don't know what the, if they have a certain amount of volume, but basically you can send the shoes back to Atreyu in Austin, Texas. They will clean them, they will sanitize them, and then they will basically give them away, from what I understand, to people in need in Austin, Texas. Kind of sounds like what we do here in the studio for our running shoe giveaway. So again, $95 pre-order. Their website is down below. And then in July, if you sign up for the subscription service, $75. Again, the details, more details on their website down below. I think it's amazing. I think it's just an amazing, innovative business model. Okay, let's dive in. This is a lot of innovation happening here. Here we go. First of all, 6 millimeter drops, or as they say on the shoe, 6 millimeter offset. I frankly love. Thank you, Atreyu, for putting it right on the side of the shoe. You can see it there, 6 millimeter neutral distance road shoe, okay? Absolutely amazing. Now, here's how I'm just gonna say one idea for Atreyu is, how amazing, and this it gets too complicated because for every shoe size, the weight changes, but it would be absolutely epic if for, and I know that it gets too complicated, but for like size 11, they put the weight of the shoe on the side of the shoe. I think, because I love knowing the weight of the shoe before I buy a shoe. It just helps me know, okay, is this gonna be a long run shoe? Is it gonna be a tempo day shoe? But again, it gets a little complicated because the weight of shoes change depending on the size. But anyway, there you go. There's the drop, 6 millimeter, 21 millimeter, 21 and a half is what their website says, but 21 millimeter stack height in the heel, 15 in the forefoot for that 6 millimeter drop. And I tried to do my best measuring. There it is on your screen with my caliper gauge, all right? So I'm getting a pretty close measurement to what they are posting on their website. So I'm gonna put it into the low to medium category for stack height in the Atreyu for the weight. Now I will say, unisex sizing right now, okay? It's a brand new startup company, so they don't have men and women weight or sizing or fit, okay? So it's one size fits all for everybody. So for the weight, for this unisex size is 5.6 ounces in size 9, okay? But in my on my scale, in my size, I'm seeing 5.7. Who knows? My scale could be off. It's not the highest end scale, but there it is on your screen, and there it is on your screen in grams. But we're talking really, really lightweight, neutral road running shoe. Like anything under 6 ounces is just screaming lightweight. I love what they're doing, keeping the shoe weight down and keeping it overall simple through that upper. And in fact, let's dive into the upper right now. It's one piece of form-fitting upper, okay? If I had to put, all right, and you know, they may not like me putting it in the same category, but I'm gonna say it kind of feels like a Skechers upper, frankly. I'm just gonna pull the Razor 3 off the shelf. Like, it kind of has that same similar thickness and overall feel to it as you rub your fingers over it. So anyway, if you're familiar with Skechers, it kind of has that same feel through the upper. Okay, now let's move on to the heel counter. Very malleable, very flexible heel counter, okay? And it does have a pull tab there on the back. Jumping to the eyelet chain, it does have a runner's knot hole, okay? Not all shoes come with that extra hole on the top for the runner's knot. I love the runner's knot. If you haven't seen the vlog about how to tie a runner's knot, upper right-hand corner, you can go watch that. And I just love that upper hole to really get a nice, good lockdown around the heel collar. Overall, incredibly comfortable. So the tongue of the shoe, it's not gusseted, which is, you know, that's fine. But the tongue is pretty thin, but lacing up today, it just laid on top of the foot really nicely, really comfortably. A very simple eyelet chain, not too confusing, not too many bells and whistles, very, very opposite end of the scale compared to yesterday's Ultra Pro Vision 4s, okay? So overall though, very comfortable lacing up through that upper. I'm impressed with the upper. I will say, I'll have to do a little more testing for the breathability factor, and it's gonna be really interesting to see once the temperatures, let's say, get above 90 degrees, degrees Fahrenheit, what happens through that upper. And moving on to that midsole, so you see written right on the side of the midsole there, strike here. So what they're promoting is a midfoot strike more so than the heel, more so than, let's say, toward the forefoot or more up on your toes, which frankly, most people do strike midfoot. Like, it's really, I've been trying to really work in this marathon training block on focusing on more of a forefoot strike, especially for faster tempo days, threshold days. But for this shoe, they're really, but for most people, a midfoot strike is just spot on, frankly. So that is what this new running shoe company is promoting, is right there through the midfoot. Now, that stack height, 21 in the heel, 15 in the forefoot, but hold your horses, everybody. Pull out the sock liner, pull it out. This is the thickest, and it is glued down just a little bit, so I actually had to kind of rip mine out earlier in the other shoe, and there we go, I got it out. So it's, yep, it's fresh glue right there. So here we go, everybody. The thickest sock liner or insole that you have ever seen. Very comfortable. Now, I measured it earlier, and I'm just going to measure it again at 6.8 millimeters, and now it's actually, now after a run, it's kind of squished down to about 5.5 millimeters, which is fine. And so not only are you getting that 21 millimeter stack height in the heel, plus this, you're actually looking more so at about a 26 millimeter stack height. So just that extra cushion, it felt really nice, very comfortable. I really like this sock liner. Now I will say I'm not sensing a ton of extra arch support. I felt it just a little bit today, so keep that in mind. Like, it's a very malleable sock liner, but overall very well cushioned. So if you're a little concerned about the lower stack height, like, you know, 15 in the forefoot is not that much, you're gonna make up for it pretty well in the sock liner that you just have to pull out and kind of analyze there. So pretty cool stuff. And I'm just wondering if Atreyu is thinking that when people send the shoes back in to be given back out to folks who need them, I'm wondering if they're gonna put, I don't know, maybe this is too much, but maybe they're gonna put a fresh sock liner inside. Who knows? Maybe that's an idea that they can look at. Okay, now it's a rubberized EVA midsole material, which means that the EVA is extra tough, all right? We shall see how long that, so also, well, let's just jump into it. The outsole, there's no extra rubber. Also, there's no extra overlays on the upper. There's no extra rubber on the outsole. Very simplified, strip down, just get the job done type of running shoe, okay? No extra bells and whistles in this guy. But because the EVA midsole is rubberized, it should last, I'm gonna say, quite a while. And I'll just give my prediction now. I'm gonna say 400, maybe 500 miles. I don't know, 400 to 500, I'd hope. And the tread pattern is just fine. I don't know, yeah, it wasn't raining today, but it looks like it would do just fine in wet conditions. And moving on to the fit and the comfort. Fit, true to size, no issues. Fit is spot on. For the comfort, it's not a plush upper by any means. In fact, it's the opposite of a plush upper. So very simplified, but again, comfortable through the upper. I will say that the foot strike on the pavement today felt a little firm, especially at slower speeds, okay? So it just felt a little firm, but I will say at faster speeds, it started to feel better and better, and that's why I stopped halfway, two-thirds of the way through the run today, and I just had to update you on, okay, it's starting to open up a little bit, letting it marinate on the foot. So I'm gonna say that I wanna take this shoe, in fact, I'll just say right now, I will use this shoe for a tempo day very, very soon. I'm still testing because of that weight, 5.7 ounces in my size. That is very lightweight. This definitely has potential to be a tempo day shoe. Who knows? Maybe even a race day shoe. And at $95, hello, like, I mean, I would maybe a half marathon or 10K shoe. Probably not probably wouldn't grab for it for a 5K, but you know, 10K or half marathon, this could have potential, absolutely. And I almost forgot, this is called the Voyager. Love the name, the Atreyu Voyager, okay? I almost forgot to mention that. It's so cool to just be holding a brand new shoe that's just entering. So Atreyu Voyager is the name, and who is this shoe best for? My thesis is that somebody who wants some decent ground contact feel, definitely a neutral roadrunner, absolutely. We'll do the twist test. Yeah, definitely neutral. And someone who really enjoys being in control of the shoe and in control of their foot strike and, what I noticed today, their toe off. So through the foot strike, you got your landing, you got your transition, and then you've got your toe off, okay? So when you actually are leaving the ground, and when I put a little more thought, and this is where you have to do a little more work when you're out there running versus, okay, I'm just gonna say right now, on the 50-mile run 3 days ago, I opted for the Glide Ride because, frankly, the Glide Ride kind of, I think it kind of does a little bit of the work for you. You're just running it through the entire swing phase and gait cycle. Like, it just, you're just smooth. Like, you're smooth. And I like that for a 50-mile run when I wanted a lot of help. But for the Atreyu today, on the toe off, it was a lot of fun to just think and process, okay, I'm in control of my toes, of everything, and just getting a nice spring off to the next step. And I enjoyed it, but again, it's not for everybody. So anyway, I know that was a long answer, but that's my thoughts on who this shoe could be best for coming out of the gate. Again, this is not my full review. That'll happen after 50 miles. Atreyu Voyager, welcome to the marketplace. Absolutely unbelievable. Once again, their website is listed down below in case you want to go check them out. And $95. Hello. Can't beat that. That's a pretty smoking price for a brand new running shoe, and I'll keep testing it out for all of you. Question of the day: if you were designing your own running shoe, what would you incorporate into that design? Since we're talking about a brand new shoe on the marketplace, like, what would be one facet that had one facet of the shoe that had to be there, whether it's upper, midsole, outsole? Let us know. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being here. There's your mystery shoe of the day. Onward and upward. Once again, happy Passover, happy Easter, butter the bread, and let's do this. All right, everyone. I'll toss it back to, I don't even know what. You know what? We'll do a mystery toss back. Actually, we'll toss it back to 1 year ago, to April 11th, 2019, the 3 year anniversary of the vlog. All right, 1 year ago, April 11th, 2019. Absolutely unbelievable. Unbelievable. All right, everyone. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.